Students, we are discussing the chapter 4 of class 7, that is acid bases and salts. And in our previous video we have recalled the taste of a few edible substances, and some are sour, bitter, and some are salty and sweet. So they are sour, salty, sweet because they have a different chemical nature. So on the basis of chemical nature, substances can be grouped into acid bases and salts. And we were discussing about the acids in detail, and we know that the word acid is come from a Latin word, acidus or acer, which means sour. So acids can be further categorized into organic acids and mineral acids. Organic acids are called the natural acids, which are safe to consume, and these are weak acids, means they do not harm to us if we consume them. And we have also discussed that some organic acids are present in natural sources like amla and citrus fruits contain ascorbic acid, lemons and oranges contain the citric acid, gourd contain lactic acid. And similarly, sometimes you have noticed that a wasp or an ant stung you, then what will happen? It will cause itching, because the sting of the bees and red ants, as well as wasp and the stinging nettle, they also contain an acid that is called formic acid, and which cause a very shooting pain and very irritation on that area. Now today we will discuss the mineral acids in detail. The mineral acids, as the name indicates, they are generally manufactured in factories, and these are highly concentrated. The acid prepared from the minerals of the earth are called mineral acids, and they are human made or man made acid, and they are also known as the laboratory acid. Why they are known as the laboratory acid? Because they are used in the science laboratory to perform experiments. And the most common mineral acids are sulfuric acid, and its formula is H2SO4. Another one is nitric acid, its formula is HNO3. And another one is hydrochloric acid, HCl. Now, I think we have also discussed about the HCl in our lesson number 2, digestion in animals. So, we know that a small amount of hydrochloric acid is always produced in the stomach. It means it is useful for us. And we know that a small amount of hydrochloric acid that is produced in our stomach, it is useful as it can kill the harmful bacteria in our stomach that may enter along with the food. But what will happen if there is an excess of acid is produced in our stomach? If excess of HCl acid is produced in our stomach, then there is a burning sensation in the stomach, and we should take some medicines to cure it. We will discuss about this in later videos. So these are the mineral acids that are present in that are very useful. And now we will discuss the properties of mineral acids. Mineral acids are very strong and they are dangerous. They are highly corrosive in nature. Highly corrosive means they have the ability to corrode the metals, and it is for this reason that they are generally stored in a glassware. For example, if we store HCl or any one of these acid in a metallic container, then what will happen? It will corrode, it will destroy the metallic container. That is why they are generally stored in a glassware or glass bottle. And acids are soluble in water, means they are easily mixed with water. These acids can cause severe burn to the skin if by chance they fall on our body or any part of our body. And these acids should be handled with great care. Why these acids should be handled with the great care? Because they are corrosive in nature and they cause severe burn to the skin. They should never be handled with bare hands and should not be tasted. And we have already discussed about the concentrated and dilute acids. and on the basis of amount of water present in an acid, it is categorized into two types: dilute acid and concentrated acid. The acidic acid solution, which has a small quantity of water and a large quantity of acid, is called concentrated acid. And concentrated acid is almost pure form of an acid. And on the other hand, dilute acids are the acidic solution, which has a large quantity of water and a small quantity of acid, is called a dilute acid. Now the question arises, how concentrated acids can be diluted? Now we can dilute the concentrated solution. It is important to know, concentrated acid can be diluted by dissolving it in a large quantity of water. But you have to remember one thing, that an acid is added to water. For example, this is acid and this is water. Acid is added to the water, not water is added to the acid. Why? Because it is an exothermic reaction, a reaction in which heat is released during the chemical reaction. So the dilution of an acid is also an exothermic reaction in which heat is released. So it must be handled with care. Now we will discuss the uses of mineral acids. These mineral acids are widely used. So first of all, we will discuss the uses of sulfuric acid. Remember one thing, sulfuric acid is known as the king of chemical. The question arises, which chemical is known as the king of chemical? Sulfuric acid is known as the king of chemicals. So what is the formula of sulfuric acid? You know that we have discussed in our lesson number 3, chemical substances and processes. It is H2SO4, sulfuric acid. And why it is known as the king of chemical? As it is an important industrial chemical and it is widely used in almost all the chemicals. That is why it is known as king of chemical. It is used in car batteries also, and it is used to produce fertilizer. These are the chemical substances that are nutrient specific and are added to the soil to increase the soil fertility. We will discuss about the fertilizer in chapter crop and production of plants. Another one is nitric acid. It is used to manufacture explosives like TNT. TNT stands for trinitrotoluene. It is used for making the explosive material, and nitroglycerin. And it is also used by the goldsmith to clean gold and silver ornaments. Your mother generally give her jewelry to the goldsmith, old jewelry to the goldsmith, to clean it. And goldsmith generally use the nitric acid and sulfuric acid solution, that is called the royal water, to clean the jewelry. Another one is hydrochloric acid. It is used for cleaning sanitary wear. You have generally seen that in the TV there is an ad of Harpic, blue Harpic and red Harpic. That is used, blue one is used for the cleaning the sanitary wear like commode of toilet, and red Harpic is used for cleaning the tiles. So they contain the hydrochloric acid that used to clean the sanitary wear. It is used in the purification of common salt. You know that common salt is used, is prepared by the crystallization or evaporation method by collecting the sea water in a ditches. So to purify the common salt or to remove the impurities, HCl is used. It is also used in the manufacture of paints and detergents that we are used in our homes for cleaning the clothes. Another one is acetic acid. Actually it is organic acid. Let's discuss. It is used in food to enhance the flavor of food. You have generally seen that the Chinese food like noodles or anything else, they generally have a tangy flavor because acetic acid is added in it. And it is also vinegar or acetic acid is added to many packaged food items like sauce, pickles, etc. It prevents the growth of the microorganism and it also provides a tangy taste to the food item. And it is also used as a cleaning agent to clean floors and utensils. You have generally seen that there is a colon that is also used as a cleaning agent, and it is used to remove stains on carpet and woodwork acetic acid is a weak acid and it is used as a preservative in pickles. We have already discussed about it. Now, so there is home assignment for you. Question first is, write the properties of acids. Differentiate between concentrated and dilute acids. Name the three acids used in laboratories and write two uses of each. And how concentrated acids can be diluted. So in our next video, we will discuss about the bases, their properties and common bases and their uses. Thank you.